Hello. In this session, we are going to discuss about the cooling rate in the context of welding. The final microstructure of weld zone and heat affected zone is primarily determined by the cooling rate from the peak temperature attained due to weld thermal cycle during welding. The diagram has been shown for the cooling diagram of hypoeutectoid steel. In this diagram, letter A, F, P, B, and M indicates the region of austenite, ferrite, perlite, bainite, and martensite respectively. In this diagram, we can easily observe that how the cooling rate matters and results in the end phases after the solidification. During welding, two welding parameters dictate the cooling rate. The first is net heat input during the welding, and the second is initial plate temperature besides the thermal and dimensional properties of the material being welded. Net heat input, H net, during the welding is obtained using this equation, which says H net is equals to FVI divided by S, where V is the voltage, I is the current in amperes, S is the welding speed expressed in millimeter per second, and F is the fraction of heat generated and transferred to the plate. As far as cooling rate calculation is concerned, there are two different empirical equations which are used for calculating the cooling rate of heat affected zone, each for thin plate and thick plate. Two methods have been proposed to take the decision whether to use thick plate or thin plate equation for calculating the cooling rates, and these are based on number of passes required for completing a weld and relative plate thickness. The relative plate thickness criteria is more logical as it considers all the relevant factors which can affect the cooling rate, such as thickness of the plate, heat input, initial plate temperature, temperature of interest at which cooling rate is desired, and physical properties of the plate like specific heat and density. Relative plate thickness tau can be calculated using the following equation. From this equation, if the value of tau is less than 0.6, thin plate cooling rate equation is used. If the tau value is more than 0.9, then thick plate cooling plate equation is used. In any case, if the value of tau is more than and equal to 0.6 and less than or equal to 0.9, if the tau value is within this range, then 0.75 is used as the limit value to decide the cooling rate equation to be used. Cooling rate equation for the thin plate is also given here, which is marked as equation 1. Now here we can see the cooling rate equation for the thick plate marked as equation 2. In both the equation, H represents the plate thickness, K represents the thermal conductivity, rho represents the density, C represents the specific heat, Ti represents the temperature of interest, and T naught represents the plate temperature. Cooling rate equation can be used to calculate the critical cooling rate under a given set of welding conditions and to determine the preheat temperature requirement for the plate in order to avoid CCR. Thank you.